Good afternoon, brothers and sisters.
弟兄姊妹们，下午好。
Good afternoon.
下午好。
Usually this happens in the morning.
一般早上才会发生这个情况。
I don't know if what's going on in the afternoon that it happens.
我不知道下午发生这个情况为了什么。
That people are not awake.
大家都没睡醒吗？
So hopefully, the word of God can wake people up.
我们希望神的话语可以让大家稍微清醒一点。
So today is a little special.
今天是一个非常独特的日子。
The afternoon brother Kevin Zhang was speaking in the AM in the morning.
下午堂的张泽宏弟兄在上午传讲信息。
他叫张泽宏。
嗯。
Okay. Afternoon, I will come here to share the word of God with you.
下午堂李佳伟弟兄在这里。
So let us all turn our Bible to 2 Thessalonians chapter 1.
我们一起来看帖撒罗尼迦后书第一章。
We finished Thessalonians first Thessalonians.
我们已经帖撒罗尼迦前书已经全讲完了。
So we are here to look at start the book of 2 Thessalonians.
我们现在开始讲后书。
So we're going to read from chapter 1 verse 1 through 5.
我们一起来读第一章的一到五节。
Verses 1 through 5, we can all read in English and in Chinese all together.
我们可以读英文和中文一起读。
Okay, 1, 2, 3. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy, to the Church of the Thessalonians in God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.We are always to give thanks to God for you, brothers, as it is right, because your faith is growing abundantly and the love of every one of you for one another is increasing. Therefore, we ourselves boast about you in the church of God for your steadfastness and faith in all your persecutions and in the afflictions that you are enduring. This is evidence of the righteous judgment of God that you may be considered worthy.Of the kingdom of God for which you're also suffering. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for giving us your words.
主啊，我们感谢你，谢谢你给我们你的话语。
Lord, we know that every single word in the Bible is precious.
主啊，我们知道圣经中每一句话都是何等宝贵。
Lord, you are there. You write these words to describe to us who you are.
主啊，你亲自写了这些话。来向我们展示你是谁。
Lord, and that these words may help us to keep us following you.
主啊，愿这些话语能够帮助我们，让我们来跟随你。
Lord, we need your mercy and your grace.
主啊，我们需要你的恩典，需要你的怜悯。
So that we may understand what it is that you are trying to say to us.
以至于我们可以理解你想向我们讲什么。
And may these words not just be words alone.
求这些话语不仅仅是词语。
May these words become our lives.
让这些话语成为我们的生命的一部分。
And that we may mature and grow in front of you.
并且我们可以在你的里面成长成熟。
And we pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
奉耶稣基督的名。
Amen.
Amen.
So the title that I've given to this message is called Don't Worry, I'm Still Here.
今天的信息的题目是别担心，我还在这儿。
Don't Worry, I'm Still Here.
别担心，我还在这儿。
I'm not sure about you, but I know that sometimes in my heart,
我不知道你们啊，有时候在我的心里，
I'm not quite sure whether our God or Lord Jesus Christ is there.
我有时候不太确定神或者说主耶稣是否真的在那儿。
And even if they're there,
就算他们在，
whether it really matters to me,
对我有什么关系吗？
You know, a lot of times we go to Bible studies, we come to Sunday gathering, and it appears that we are good in following our Lord.
我们常常去主日学，我们常常去圣经查考圣经来主日，我们会觉得说我们在主里我们都好。
But if we truly we are honest with ourselves,
但是如果我们真实的面对自己
，sometimes we will ask,
有时候我们就会问自己
，God, are you really there?
神呢？你真的在那儿吗？
Why is it that it sounds to me that you are silent?
为什么你对我总是保持沉默？
Why does it sound to me that if you're there, but it's as if you are not there?
就算你真的在那儿，为什么让我感觉你不在呢？
You know, my struggles,
我自己的挣扎，
my wishes,
我所想要的
my wants, my doubts,
我需要的和我所有的疑惑。
You know, we know that we don't live in a difficult time like the Thessalonians did.
我们知道我们不像这些帖撒罗尼迦弟兄姊妹生活在一个非常艰难的时代。
We don't have as much of the persecutions that they're facing every day in their lives.
我们没有面像他们一样每天都在面对这些被逼迫。
After this service, right? After today's worship, it's about 5 p.m., right?
今天我们的聚会结束之后，大概五点钟。
What would you all be thinking about at 5 p.m.?
各位弟兄姊妹，五点钟左右都在会想什么呢？
I know what I would be thinking about.
我知道我会想什么。
I'm home alone right now.
我现在是孤家寡人。
My family are all in China.
我的家人都在中国。
I'll be thinking about what to eat for dinner.
我会在想说晚上吃什么呢？
Many of you will be thinking about what to eat for dinner.
我想我们当中很多人也会这么想。
But you know, the Thessalonian brothers and sisters at that time, they will be thinking about how to survive till next week.
当时帖撒罗尼迦弟兄姊妹们，他们可能想的是如何能够继续的活下去，活到下一周为止。
You know, we don't have that kind of persecution.
我们没有那样子的逼迫。
But in our lives, we still struggle.
但是在我们的生命中，我们还是常常的会挣扎。
We still struggle to continue to follow the Lord Jesus Christ faithfully.
我们常常挣扎着，是因为我们想要非常忠实的跟随我们的主耶稣。
You know, now we come to the second letter that Paul wrote to the Thessalonians.
今天我们一起来看第二封保罗写给帖撒罗尼迦弟兄姊妹的书信。
You know, the time that passed between the first letter and the second letter is about, some say, a couple months, some say up to a year, not very long.
在第一封保罗写给他们的书信和第二封书信之间呢，有人说可能有几个月时间，有人说可能有将近一年，不是太久。
It's not very long.
不是很久。
But why did Paul write a letter back to the same church in such a short amount of time?
但是保罗为什么这么快就给同一间教会再次写信呢？
Yeah, but if you read on a little bit into 2 Thessalonians, you will see in chapter 2.
你如果继续往下读的话，你就会在帖撒罗尼迦后书的第二章里面找到答案。
You will find out that they started to have a saying that's circulating in the church.
你就会发现在教会当中有一些传闻。
That there's a report in the church and it's spreading fast.
有一个这个教会里面有个传闻，而且传播的非常快。
It says, hey, you, all of you in 1 Thessalonians, right? You are waiting for the Lord Jesus to come back.
哎，各位，你们都在等主耶稣再来的时候。
You are suffering.
你们都在痛苦着。
Your life is difficult.
你们都很难过。
But there's hope. But there's hope.
但是有希望。
Jesus is coming back.
耶稣要再来。
And now there's this news, this report circulating in the church.
现在呢，坊间有个新的传闻。
That Jesus already came back.
就是耶稣已经回来了。
That Jesus already came back, and guess what? They're left alone.
耶稣已经回来了。但是呢，你却被留在这里继续等待。
That they are left alone.
你被留下来了。
You know, in the first Thessalonians, it was described that these brothers and sisters, they lived in persecutions.
在第一封书信里面提到说，这些弟兄姊妹们在被控告当中生活着。
But they had be poor. They live in be poor, right? And it was described that they have faith.
但是呢，他们却有信心。
And this faith is bigger than anything.
这个信心超过一切。
This faith brought them hope.
这个信心让他们有希望。
And this hope gave them the perseverance to be able to endure the persecutions.
这个希望让他们能够有坚忍，能够忍耐这些逼迫。
And it allowed them to remain in their faith.
能够让他们持续在他们的信心当中。
It was a comfort for them.
对他们是一个何等大的安慰。
That they know that one day they will see the Lord Jesus Christ.
他们知道有一天他们会在与主再见面。
And that all the pains and sufferings will be gone.
所有的痛苦，所有的挣扎都会消失。
It will all be in the past.
都会成为过去。
And they will be with the Lord Jesus Christ.
他们和主耶稣基督在一起。
That's the comfort for them.
那是对他们最大的安慰。
But now this news came.
但是现在新来一个新闻。
The Lord Jesus Christ already came.
主耶稣基督已经来了。
To them, they're in shock.
对他们来说，他们实在是太惊讶了。
What? Wait a minute. How can it be?
等等，怎么可能呢？
Jesus already came.
耶稣已经来了吗？
Wait, Paul, didn't Paul tell us that when Jesus comes, we will meet with Jesus in the clouds?
保罗不是告诉我们说，当主耶稣再来的时候，我们要和主在云中相会吗？
If Jesus already came, but we are still here suffering.
如果主已经来了，我们却还在这里继续的受苦。
The government doesn't like us.
政府不喜欢我们。
My neighbor doesn't like us.
我们的邻居不喜欢我们。
And there are some Jewish people walking around, wandering around, just punishing, hitting, killing people.
有一些犹太人走来走去，为的是要抓捕，是要迫害，是要对我们不好。
If Jesus already came, why are we still here?
如果耶稣已经来了，为什么我还在这儿呢？
There's a possibility now.
哦，有个可能。
Oh, that.They were not saved.
啊，他们没有得救。
That Jesus already came and they were left alone.
主耶稣已经来了，但是他们却被留在原地。
It's as if you're on the platform waiting for a train.
好像你在等月台上等火车。
If you, I remember last time. There's one time I was sharing with brothers and sisters my business trip experience. You know, waiting for the train in Great Britain, in England.
我记得不久前我跟弟兄姊妹分享过我在出差的时候在英国等火车的一次悲惨经历。
The train that will never come.
那个火车从来没有来。
Oh, the Great British Empire, they cannot get the trains right.
大英帝国竟然不能让一个小小的火车。
Right, but it's as if they're on the platform waiting for the train.
对于这兄弟兄姊妹来讲，他们就像在月台上等火车一样。
They know the train will come one day.
他们知道火车一定会来。
And the train will take them away.
火车会带他们到
他们要去的地方。Not only that, there is this guy called Paul.
不仅如此，还有一个叫保罗的人。
He wrote a letter to tell us the train will come.
他给我们写了一封信，说这个火车一定会来。
And they will take us away.
还会把我们带走。
But now there's this other report.
但是这里却有另外一个新闻。
The train already came, and you guys are still left on the platform.
火车已经来，而我却在月台。
所以说 Paul wrote this letter to them.
保罗写了第二封书信。
To encourage them.
来鼓励他们。
To assure them.
来向他们确信。
That they did not believe in the wrong person.
他们并没有相信错人。
That their faith is not in vain.
他们的信心是何等的真实，并不是徒然的。
That what they believed in is still there.
他们所相信的还是在那儿。
What they hope for is still to come.
他们所期望的不远会来。
And most importantly,
更重要的是
in this passage, in the first five verses that we read,
在这五节我们要读的经文里面
that they are suffering right now, yes.
他们正在 受伤害受痛苦
But it is actually the proof that God is still there.
但是却是神在那里的明证
And that God is still working in their lives.
神还是在他们生命当中做工
It is exactly because of their suffering and persecutions.
正是因为他们所经历的痛苦
That God is still there in their lives.
神还在他们的生命中。
That they have not been left alone.
他们并没有被落下来。
So in the first five verses here that we read,
在前面的五个节里面
Paul gave them four assurances.
保罗给他们四个确信。
These four assurances are trying to encourage brothers and sisters there.
这个四个确信是为了鼓励这些弟兄姊妹们。
To tell them that, hey, the Lord Jesus' workDid not stop.
告诉他们说，主耶稣的工作并没有停滞。
And to tell the Thessalonian brothers and sisters that they don't need to worry.
也告诉帖撒罗尼迦弟兄姊妹们不要担心。
That what they hope for is still to come.
你们所期盼的马上就会来。
So let's take a look at the four assurances.
我们一起来看看这四个确信是什么。
Oh, can you read? Is it big enough? Four assurances. First assurance.
第一个
Let's take a look at the first two verses.
我们一起来看前两节
Okay, in white. Okay, in white font.
白色字
White font, right? So I will read. Okay. So it says, Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy to the church of the Thessalonians in God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
保罗、希拉、提摩太写信给帖撒罗尼迦，在神我们的父与主耶稣基督的教会，愿恩惠、平安从父神和主耶稣基督归于你们。
So this is the first assurance.
这是第一个确信。
You know, in verses 1 and 2,
在第一到二节里面
If you read back to the first letter in 1 Thessalonians
如果你和帖撒罗尼迦前书第一封书信对比
You will find this is a very very similar opening
你会发现这是一个非常相似的开头
The greeting is almost the same
这个问候呢，基本上是一样的。
You can see that Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy, they are still serving together at this point.
你可以看到这里，保罗、希拉和提摩太还是在一起同工。
Before in 1 Thessalonians, they were serving together. Now they are still serving together.
在帖撒罗尼前书里面，他们是在一起服侍，他们如今还在一起。
And that they are still together caring for the church of Thessalonica.
他们还是在一起关怀、关照。
But if you look at these two verses carefully,
但是你如果看看这两节经文，仔细的看
you can see that there is similarities between 1st and 2nd Thessalonians.
你会发现他们前书和后书的这问候有类似
But you can also see there's a big difference between the 1st and the 2nd Thessalonians.
这里面还有一个很大的不同
Both The similarity and the difference, they all provide an assurance to the Thessalonian brothers and sisters.
这个相同和不同都给帖撒罗尼迦弟兄姊妹们一个确信。
Let's look at this. I'll tell you what the assurance is.
我来告诉你这个确信是什么。
But follow me first, okay?
但是请跟着我。
Let's go through the same.
我们一起来。
What's the similarities between the two introductions?
前书和后书的开头的类似是什么呢
？First of all, it mentioned that they all both mention that they are a church that is in God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
首先，这里提到他们两个都提到说，帖撒罗尼迦教会是一个在神我们的父与主耶稣基督里的教会。
That it's a church that's in God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
是一个。教会在主我们父神和主耶稣基督里。
If you look at the word church,
如果你看这个教会这个词
，this word church,
这个词
，just generically means assembly.
它最大的意思就是一个聚集
，assembly of a group of people,
一群人的聚集。
You can have a church, assembly of different purposes.
你可以为着不同的原因而聚集。
The same word actually describes that there is a mob or an assembly of Jewish people.
这个词呢，常常用来形容一群犹太人的聚集。
Or an assembly of several thousand people.
或者上千人的聚集。
Okay, but here, what's special about this assembly?
但是这里这个聚集有什么特别之处呢
？Is that this assembly is the assembly of God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ？
这个聚集是因为它是在神我们的父和主耶稣基督里的。
That every day there are so many different assemblies in the city of Thessalonica。
每一天在帖撒罗尼迦有各种各样的聚集。
They assemble for different purposes。
他们为着不同的目的而聚集。
Most of the time they assemble for fun。
大多时候他们是为了找乐子。
Sometimes they assemble for political reasons.
有时候是为了一些政治目的。
But what's interesting about this assembly, what's so special about this assembly, is that this assembly belongs to God.
但是这个聚集的独特之处就是它是归于神的。
And that this assembly is not because they wanted to satisfy their own purpose.
这个聚集不是为了他们自己自我的目的。
They assemble because they were saved. By the Lord Jesus Christ.
他们聚集是因为他们被主耶稣基督所救赎。
Today we take the church or assembly for granted because we can naturally and just come and we can drive to church.
如今我们觉得我们教会的聚集是理所当然的，因为我们很简单就来聚会了。
You know, but at that time, for them to assemble together is not that simple.
但是那个时候，当弟兄姊妹聚集的时候，却是相当的困难。
The persecutions that they face.
他们所要面对的迫害
，the pressure that they say that they face，
他们所要承受的压力
，it's not easy for them to assemble together。
对他们来说，聚集太难了。
But there they are。
但是他们在这儿呢。
All because of their special identity in the world。
都是因为他们这个特别的身份。
Out of all these assemblies，
在所有这些聚集里面
，there's this one assembly that God and the Lord Jesus Christ is watching。
有一个特别的聚集是父神和主耶稣来看顾的。
And this is the same in the 2 Thessalonians.
在帖撒罗尼迦后书里面也是这么写的。
That Paul continued to call them, "You are the assembly of God and the Lord Jesus Christ."
保罗在这里继续也说，他们是在神我们的父与主耶稣基督里的教会。
God did not leave you alone.
神并没有把你们给留下来。
Lord Jesus did not just leave you.
主耶稣也没有放弃你们。
You are not orphans.
你们不是孤儿。
You are still the assembly of God and Jesus Christ.
你们还是主我们的父与主耶稣基督的教会。
But then what's the difference?
但是区别呢？
The difference, if you look at the first letter,
如果你看第一封书信的话，
the first letter, Paul said, grace to you and peace.
第一封书信保罗说，恩惠与平安归于你。
Grace to you and peace.
恩惠与平安归于你。
And that's it, period. That's the end of the sentence.
就结束了，这就是这一句的结束。
But here in the second letter, what does Paul say?
在第二封书信里面，保罗说什么呢？
What does Paul say?
保罗说什么呢？
Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
愿恩惠平安从父神和主耶稣基督归于你们。
It's very strange, right? Verse 1, he said,God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
这有点奇怪，对吧？第一节他已经说神我们的父与主耶稣基督了。
The second verse, immediately, the second sentence, he said again, God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
第二句他又说，他说平安从父神和主耶稣基督。
If any of you have learned any kind of essay writing or letter writing, you know, in English or in Chinese,
如果你在中文或者英文里面学过论文，写论文，
you know to avoid the exact same words repeated twice in two sentences.
你可能就只有会有个常识，说你是不会把同一个词语或者短语写两遍。
But together, right, consecutively, one after the other.
离得很近，两个挨着写。
You're repeating exact same words.
你在重复同一个词。
What is Paul trying to say here?
所以保罗在这里所讲什么呢？
It's almost as if he's trying to say to the Thessalonian brothers and sisters.
他好像要对帖撒罗尼迦弟兄姊妹讲一句话。
God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ is here. Is still here, watching over you.
神我们的父与主耶稣基督还在这儿，他还在这里看观看着我们。
That this grace and this peace.It's coming from them and still coming from them.
这个恩惠和平安是从他们而来，而如今还是从他们而来。
The grace means things that we do not deserve.
恩惠是我们不配得的东西。
The perfect and complete salvation.
那个完全完美的救恩。
And the peace that gave us reconciliation with God.
平安是让我们可以和父神和好。
You know, the peace that's said here does not mean that, hey, every day you just, you know, stay alive, okay? And that's a peaceful life. No, no, no. It's not talking about peaceful life here.
平安在这里并不是讲我们过一个相安无事的一生。
The peace here that talks about is that before man and God are at war with each other.
这里的平安所讲的是，因为以前人和神是处于一个征战的状态。
That men are the enemies of God.
人类是神的敌人。
And that through this grace,
因着这样的恩惠，
now we can have peace with God.
而如今我们可以在神里面有平安。
That we can come together and have a relationship.
我们可以在一起有一个好的关系。
This grace and peace, the two precious, precious blessings in our lives.
这个恩惠和平安这两个无比珍贵的一个祝福
that they were given to the Thessalonian brothers and sisters in the first letter.
在第一封书信中就已经给了帖撒罗尼迦弟兄姊妹们。
In the second letter, Paul is reminding them again.
第二封书信里面保罗再次的提醒他们
that these blessings are still coming from God and Father, the Father and the Lord Jesus coming to them.
这些祝福呢还是从神我们的父和主耶稣基督到他们里面。
That Paul wants to emphasize.
保罗想要强调。
You are not alone.
你不是孤军一人。
God is still here watching over you.
神与你同在。
The Lord Jesus Christ is still here blessing you.
主耶稣基督还在不断的赐福于你。
This did not change.
这个没有改变。
And that's the first assurance.
这是第一个确信。
What's the second assurance?
第二个确信。
Second assurance is that our Lord, our God, actually listened to Paul's prayers and are continuing to do the great work.
第二个确信呢，是我们的神呢，在听保罗祷告，并且不停持续地在做他的善工。
That in this verse you can see, and which is verse 3, it says, We ought always to give thanks to God for you, brothers, as it is right, because your faith is growing abundantly, and the love of every one of you for one another is increasing.
第三节提到说，弟兄们，我们该为你们常常感谢神，这本是合宜的，因你们的信心格外增长，并且你们众人彼此相爱的心也都充足。
Here from this verse, you can see that God is working.
在这节经文里，你看到说神的工作没有停止。
Here you can see that God listened and answered Paul's prayers.
你看到这里，看到说神听了保罗的祷告，并且回应了他的祷告。
Why do I say that?
为什么这么讲呢？
If you recall in the first letter.
如果你在第一封书信里面你还记得的话，
Paul was so happy of the news coming from the church of Thessalonica.
保罗何等的欢喜快乐那个从帖撒罗尼迦回来的好消息。
You know why Paul was so happy?
为什么保罗如此开心呢？
Because he heard that their faith and that their love is abundant.
保罗听说他们的信心和爱心都很充足。
And Paul was so happy that he wanted to go back to them.
保罗好开心的，保罗想要回到他们当中。
Paul wanted to go back to them in order to share with them and to fellowship with them to help them to grow even more.
保罗想要回到他们当中，可以继续的和他们分享，继续的和他们聚集。
That Paul wanted their faith and love, even though they've already become great examples for that region of brothers and sisters.
虽然他们已经成为了当地信主之人的榜样，但是保罗还是想要回去和他们一起。
Remember that the Thessalonian brothers and sisters, they had a really good reputation.
你记得他们有一个很好的名声。
That they are so good that they became a good examples of love and faith for that whole region of people.
他们是如此的好，他们成为当地所有信主之人在爱心和信心里的榜样。
It's almost as saying ECTC is so good in faith and love.
有点像说，哦，ECTC的弟兄姊妹们也是如此的有信心有爱心。
That we have become the good example for Christians to follow in the tri-state area.
我们差点成了 tri-state area 弟兄姊妹的榜样。
In the Connecticut, New York, and New Jersey, you want to see what's a good church? Go to ECTC.
在这三周里面，你如果想知道是什么样是好的 church， 你去 ECTC。
By the way, believe it or not, I've actually heard about this before. And I got
nervous. 不管你信不信我，反正听过。
I got nervous. I said to the guy.
我超级惊恐啊！我跟他们讲。
You will be surely disappointed.
你会非常非常。
But come, it's okay. Come take a look.
但是 OK， 你可以来看一看。
But it's as if this is true.
但是就有点像那是真的一样。
We are the good examples of love and faith for the tri-state area, brothers and sisters.
我们是爱心和信心的榜样。
But Paul said,
但是保罗说
in the first letter writing to them,
在第一封书信里面
Oh, it's so good. I love you all so much.
你们太好了，我好爱你们。
I want to come back and share with you.
我想要回去和你们继续的分享。
I want to grow with you.
我想继续和你们一起成长。
I want to be with you.
我想与你们同在。
Did God allow him to do it?
神允许他回去了吗？
No.
并没有。
He couldn't.
他没有办法回去。
He said it to the brothers and sisters for whatever reason he doesn't know, but God is not allowing him to go back.
他写信告诉这些弟兄姊妹们，不知道为因着什么原因，神没有让他回去。
So Paul, in the first letter, continuously prayed multiple times.
所以说，在第一封书信里，保罗多次不断的鼓励。
He prayed. 祷告。
祷告。
He prayed multiple times.
多次的祷告。
That he prays that God may help them to grow in faith and love.
他向神求说，神可以继续的帮助，让他们在信心、爱心里增长。
I won't be able to come to you.
我没有办法到你们那里去。
But I pray that God can help you.
但是我求神能够帮助你们
to continue to grow，
能够继续的在它里面成长。
What do we read in the second letter here？
在第二封书信里面，我们现在读到什么呢？
It says here，
他讲到
your faith is growing abundantly，
因你们的信心格外增长。
And the love of every one of you for one another is increasing，
并且你们众人彼此相爱的心也都充足。
You see，
你看到了吗？
Paul didn't go back。
保罗并没有回去。
But Paul's prayer, God listened.
但是保罗的祷告得蒙垂听。
Indeed, their faith and love grew.
他们的信心和爱心真的成长了。
Not only just grew, but grew abundantly.
不仅仅是增长，而且是格外的增长。
This is amazing.
这实在是太奇妙了。
That God actually listened to Paul's prayers.
神在这里垂听了保罗的祷告。
You know, a lot of times we think that we are the ones serving in the church, right?
有时候我们觉得是我们是在教会服事的。
We are the ones that's encouraging other brothers and sisters.
我们是在教会里做鼓励弟兄姊妹工作的。
But as the Bible says,
但是像圣经里所讲的，
it's actually the Father that allows everyone to grow.
但是却是父神他能够让众人成长。
That if there's anyone that matures,
如果任何一个人成长成熟。
That if there's anyone that gets encouraged,
任何一个人得到鼓励。
It's not because of how good of a word I've said,
并不是我们在主里面所讲的。
It's all because of the Lord Jesus Christ and God our Father working in their lives.
都是因为我们的主耶稣和父神在我们的生命中的工作。
You know, and this is such an assurance that he is presenting to these brothers and sisters.
这是如此大的一个确信。
Hey, remember I prayed for you before for your love and faith to grow?
你记得我以前为你们的爱心和信心向父神先生祷告吗？
And indeed, your love and faith have grown abundantly.
而如今你们的爱心和信心真的格外的增长。
Not in an environment of comfort,
并不是在一个舒适的环境里。
But in an environment of pain and suffering,
但是在一个满有痛苦 满有苦难的环境中。
This is absolutely God's work,
这实在是神自己的工作。
And that is why Paul here in this verse that says it is my duty to thank God,
在这就是为什么保罗在这里说这是我的责任，我要来感谢神。
In English it says it's his duty.
英文说是 duty.
You know, sometimes I don't know how many times you thank God.
我不知道你为父神感谢多少次。
Think about it. How many times in a day do you come to the Lord Jesus and say, Jesus, I thank you?
你每天会多少次来到神的面前说，神啊，主耶稣，我感谢你。
Breakfast, lunch and dinner do not count.
早中晚饭不算啊。
Okay, we need to pray.
我们需要祷告。
They don't count.
感谢不算的。
Outside of that,
在那以外。
How many times do you come to the Lord Jesus and thank him?
多少次你来主耶稣面前说谢谢你？
I don't know about all of you.
我不晓得你们。
I know about me.
我知道我自己。
I'm busy.
我好忙啊。
Sometimes when I come and thank the Lord, it's as if I'm doing the Lord a favor.
有时候我来到神的面前感谢神，好像是我为他做了一个，我是来给他一个面子。
哎，对对对。I'm busy.
我好忙的。
I'll thank you later.
我待会儿再谢你就好了。
But sometimes there's just that voice to say no, 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 thank me now.
但是好像就有一个声音常常跟我说，就是现在。
And I'll be like, all right, I'll thank you.
我就说好吧，那我谢你喽。
Two words, two sentences.
两句话。
And done.
就结束了。
I'm just doing him a favor.
我只是给他一个面子，给他说一声而已。
You know, to Paul, he thinks it's his duty.
但对保罗来说，他觉得这是他的一个责任。
You know what it means to be his duty?
你知道作为一个责任是什么意思吗？
It means this is something that he should do.
这就是他需要做的。
He should put other things aside and do this.
他需要把其他的事情都搁在旁边，专门来做这件事情。
It's not as if, oh, when I have time, when I remember, I'll come and thank you a little bit.
并不是当我有时间的时候，当我闲的时候。
No, he is there to think that it is his duty to keep on thinking thanking the Lord Jesus Christ.
他觉得是他自己的责任，可以不住地感谢神。
After he heard of God's continuing work in the Thessalonian brothers and sisters' lives,
在他听到帖撒罗尼迦弟兄姊妹生命被神所改变的时候，
that he cannot help but come and thank the Lord Jesus Christ.
他没有办法控制住他自己，他不停不断地在感谢主耶稣。
This is God's work.
这就是神的工作。
This means that God absolutely did not leave the brothers and sisters there alone.
这代表说主真的没有把这些弟兄姊妹们留下来抛弃。
He is still listening to prayers.
他还在听着这样子祷告。
That he is still working in their lives.
他还在他们的生命当中不断的做工。
Not only just a little bit.
不是一点点。
But abundantly.
而是格外的。
Let's go to the third assurance.
第三个确信。
The third assurance. It says, Therefore, we ourselves boast about you in the churches of God for your steadfastness and faith in all your persecutions and the afflictions that you are enduring.
第三个确信经文所提到第四节说，甚至我们在神的各教会里为你们夸口，都因你们在所受的一切逼迫患难中仍旧存忍耐和信心。
The third assurance talks about that persecution is actually a gift from God.
第三个确信所讲的是他们所遭受的逼迫是神给他们的一个礼物。
That the persecution is actually by God's design given to them.
这个逼迫是神所设计的，加添给他们的。
You know, how many of you have gone through elementary schools in China or Taiwan?
我们当中有多少人在中国大陆或者台湾上了小学？
How many of you?
多少人？
Okay.For people who have gone through elementary school in China, have you ever been the good student who received, you know, the little, I don't know, red flower or whatever it is, that you are the, like, 三好学生是不是？
在
Oh!
在中国大陆，我们当中有谁上小学的时候表现特别好，所以说你可以带着小红花被称为三好学生的。
Right, you wear that, right, and say, everyone look at you.、Right?
你把它戴在胸前说看我。
The teachers will mention about you.
老师会夸你。
You will mention about you.
你自己夸自己。
Everyone will be mentioning about you.
每个人都会提到你。
Good job.
真棒。
I remember Caleb, you're one, right? Caleb,
加了以前。
Right, this is something to boast about.
这是人可以夸口的。
You know, we men, we love to boast about accomplishments.
我们特别喜欢夸口我们自己的成功。
We love to boast about, good things.
我们特别喜欢为一些好的事情夸口。
I remember a couple months ago in January, I went to the Pentagon.
我记得几个月前一月份我去了五角大厦。
I went to the Pentagon to receive an award.
我去五角大厦去领取一个奖励。
And I remember bringing that award, you know, of the year. Okay, I won something of the year award, and I took it from a four-star general, and immediately I was like texting my mom and my dad. Look.
我那时候得到一个什么某某之最的一个奖。那是直接一个四星的将军颁发给我的。我刚拿到那个奖杯，我就赶紧给我爹娘发了一封短信。
I didn't send it to the whole church, but I sent it to my small family group.
我没有给教会大群里发，但是我在我们教会的我们小家小群里发的。
I was in the subway waiting for the train to come to pick me up, and I was like, let me send this.
我在地铁等火车的时候，我就把这个信息给发了。
We love to boast about accomplishments.
我们都很喜欢夸口。都很喜欢讲我们自己的成就。
Maybe it's grades.
有时候可能是我们的成绩。
Maybe it's good job.
有时候是我们的工作。
You know, maybe you won't be so, you know, showy on that.
有时候你可能太喜欢 show.
No, maybe you will not be so showy.
哦，有时候你可能不是那么爱现。
But sometimes in the sentences, you'll just say you can't help but say, oh, I just got hired by Google.
但是有时候你可能很低调的凡尔赛一下，说我被 Google 给录取了。
Oh, I just bought a Tesla. No, nothing. Oh, I just bought a Rivian.
我刚买了一个特斯拉或者是 Rivian.
Right? What do we like to boast about?
我们喜欢夸什么呢？
But what is Paul boasting about?
但是保罗在夸什么呢？
What is Paul boasting about?
保罗夸口的对象是什么？
Paul is boasting about their steadfastness in their persecutions.
保罗所夸口的乃是这些弟兄姊妹们在逼迫患难中仍旧存忍耐和信心。
What does steadfast mean?
忍耐是什么呢？
Steadfast means not to waver.
忍耐就是不动摇。
Steadfast means not to sway around with the waves.
忍耐呢，就是不是随波逐流。
You know, I don't know how many of you invest in the stock market.
我不知道你们多少人炒股。
You know, to waver means to your emotion at a daily basis goes up and down with the stock market.
被波动呢，就像你的心情常常被股市所波动一样。
You know, to waver means that your faith towards the Lord Jesus Christ
摇晃就是你的信心对着耶稣。
Goes up and down according to what God has given you and what He has not given you.
上上下下，仅仅是因为主给你的什么，或者没有给你什么。
Waver means your faith towards God changes according to your surroundings.
摇晃呢，就是说你对神的信心呢，是根据你周围的环境所决定的。
What happens to you?
那什么对有什么事情在你身上发生呢？
What did not happen to you?
或者有什么事情没有在你身上发生？
Will all affect how you follow the Lord Jesus.
都成为了你跟随耶稣的根据。
But you know, as Christians, we need to change our perspective a little bit.
但是你知道吗？作为基督徒，我们需要改变我们的眼光。
In the book of Romans, chapter 5,
在罗马书第五章。
I'll just read. Don't worry about, you know, we can generalize it. You know, in chapter 5, verses 3 to 5, it says, we to rejoice in our sufferings.Knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, character produces hope, and hope does not put us to shame.
罗马书第五章三到五节提到说，就是在患难中也要欢欢喜喜的，因为知道患难生忍耐，忍耐生老练，老练生盼望，盼望不至于羞耻。
You know, suffering produces endurance.
患难生忍耐。
Endurance, character.
忍耐生老练
character hope
可以让我们有盼望。
You see, it's a fact of life.
这就是生命的法则。
That the character of endurance,
忍耐所产生的。
That the character of steadfastness,
忍耐所造就的。
Sometimes,
有时候
it comes from the deepest sufferings.
有时候甚至是最深最深的苦难。
A lot of times, what God wants to build in our lives.
有时候神想在我们生命中重建的。
The characters that He wants us to have.
是我们自己的品格，他想让我们所有的品格。
Is built from the deepest sufferings.
常常是从我们最深深的痛苦当中建立起来。
We may think, oh, how unfortunate.
有时候我们想说，好不幸哦。
I just want a comfortable life.
我就是想舒舒服服的。
I just want God to help me and pave the way, the path for me forward.
我就是想让我给我神给我一条舒坦的道路。
But you can see that in so many places in the Bible.
但是你看到在圣经中太多地方。
That this is God's design.
神的设计就是这样子。
That we will grow, we will mature.
我们成长。
In the midst of sufferings,
是基于我们的受苦。
You know, there is a person called Laura Story.
有一个叫 Laura Story 的人。
She's a very, very famous Christian songwriter, Laura Story.
她是一个很有名的基督的歌曲的写作者。
I don't know how many of you have heard of her story.
不晓得你们有多少人听过。
One year into her new marriage,
在她的婚姻的第一年。
Her husband was diagnosed with brain tumor.
她的丈夫被诊断出来脑瘤。
So essentially, after the first year of marriage, most of their time is spent in emergency rooms in the hospital.
所以说，除了他们第一年以外，他们其他的时间 都是在急救间和医院里面度过。
Her husband still lives.
她的丈夫现在还活着。
But has already lost the vision.
但是已经看不见了。
Her husband still lives.
她的丈夫现在还活着。
But is paralyzed.
但是已经残疾了，永远残疾。
She couldn't understand at that time why God gave this kind of suffering into her life.
她没有办法理解神怎么给她如此痛苦的一生。
She cannot understand why is it that all she wanted was a normal life.
她没有办法理解，因为她想要的仅仅是一个正常的生活而已。
But God did not allow her to have it.
但是神却不给她。
But it is in during that time of pain and suffering.
但是就在那块最痛苦的时候。
When she cannot understand, but yet she held on to God.
她虽然没有办法理解，但是她还紧紧地抓住神。
That she wrote the song called Blessings.
她写了一首歌叫做 Blessings.
I truly recommend you go and listen to that song.
我非常鼓励你们去听这首歌。
It's called Blessing by Laura, and her name, last name is Story, 故事 Story. That's her name.
叫做 Blessings, 祝福，从 Laura Story 写的。
In her song, she wrote these sentences.
在他的歌里面，他写了如此几句话。
She asked these questions.
他问了这几个问题。
What if your blessings come through raindrops?
如果你的祝福是从雨滴中来的呢？
What if your hearing, your healing comes through tears?
你的医治是从你的眼泪中来的呢？
What if the greatest blessings of my life?Is coming from the nights that I'm suffering through.
如果我所有最大的祝福和怜悯都是从那些无法入眠的夜晚来的呢？
What if the trials of this life, the rain, the storms, the hardest nights, are your mercies in disguise?
我这一生所经历的最难过的这些路、这些道路、这些风浪、这些波折，都是你要给我的祝福。
This is her own song.
这是她所写的歌。
This is her own life.
这是她自己的生命。
Her character is being built in the deepest sufferings of life.
她的品格在她最大的痛苦当中被建立出来。
As the book of James said,
在雅各书里面提到说。
It says that when you have trials and difficulties in life,
自己说当你们落在百般试炼当中的时候，
you need to have great joy.
你都要有大喜乐。
Not just joy,
不是一般的喜乐，
but great joy.
大喜乐。
Why?
为什么？
Because the book says, you know that the testing of your 第三节, the testing of your faith produces steadfastness.And let steadfastness have its full effect, that you may be perfect and complete, lack in nothing.
因为这里雅各书里面还提到说，因为知道你们的信心经过试炼，就生忍耐，但忍耐也当成功，但忍耐也当成功，使你们成全完备，毫无缺乏。
When persecutions come,
当迫害来临的时候
，When difficulties come.
当困难来到的时候
，Take joy，
我们要喜乐
，Big joy，
大喜乐。
Why？
为什么
？Because this means that God is training you，
因为神在造就你。
That God is working and working and working in your lives，
神在你的生命中不断的做工
，So that you may be perfected，
以至于你可以成全
，So that you may be mature，
以至于你可以成熟。
So that you can change from a person that's constantly thinking about you.
所以你可以从一个原来只想着自己的人
That one day you can start to deny yourself.
有一天你可以舍弃自己舍己
To change someone that only loves himself.
把一个从只爱自己的人
Into someone who knows how to love God.And to love brothers and sisters.
变成一个会爱神爱人的人。
You know, the fact that these brothers and sisters in Thessalonica are able to remain steadfast in all of the persecutions.
因着帖撒罗尼迦弟兄姊妹可以在如此多的患难中可以有这样坚忍的性格。
This is the proof that God is still with them.
这就是神与他们同在的明证。
Because through these persecutions, this is exactly what God wants to do in their lives.
因为透过这些所有的挫折、所有的迫害，这就是神所要实现的工作。
It's to build them up.
是为了建造他们。
You know, brothers and sisters, we live in a place, in a world that is mostly peaceful.
你知道吗，弟兄姊妹们，我们现在住在一个相对和平的年代。
We look at our jobs, we look at our families, our surroundings.
我们看我们的工作，看我们的家庭，看我们周围一切。
And most of the time, we pray for blessings of peace.
大多数时候呢，我们都是为着这个平安和平而祷告。
And we think that if God is to bless us,
我们觉得说，如果神要祝福我们的话，
He should bless us with happy things.
他会给我们那些欢乐的东西。
With good things.
好的东西。
With things that we may or may not be like, but at least there are things that will not make us suffer.
不管他祝福我们的好或者是不好，但是至少不会让我们受苦吧。
But yet, in many different places in the Bible, including this place,
但是在圣经中的太多地方，包括在这里，
God is showing us that sometimes blessing comes from tears.
神向我们显示说，有时候他所带给人的祝福乃是透过眼泪。
Blessings come from suffering.
乃是透过痛苦。
Blessings come from pain.
乃是透过疼痛
and anger,
恼怒
Sometimes we're mad at God.
有时候我们会对神很生气
Why are you doing this?
你为什么这样对我
What have I done?
我怎么了
But God indeed will be there, is there to bless us through these sufferings.
但是神过去在，现在还在，要祝福我们
That he will turn these tears into joy.
他会让这些眼泪变成欢笑。
And this is actually the third assurance to the Thessalonians that God is still there.
这是对帖撒罗尼迦弟兄姊妹的第三个确信，神还在。
And let's come to the last one.
我们来看最后一个。
The fourth assurance.
最后一个确信。
It says, "This is the evidence of the righteous judgment of God that you may be considered worthy of the kingdom of God for which you are also suffering."
第四个确信的对应经文是：这正是神公义判断的明证，叫你们可算配得神的国。你们就是为这国受苦。
This is a very confusing verse.
这是一个让人特别混乱的一个经文。
Especially this verse is actually one sentence with verse 6.
这个经文呢
？So verse 5 and verse 6 are together.
第五节和第六节呢，其实呢还是一句话。
But today we're only going to talk till verse 5.
那今天呢，我们只讲到第五节。
And this is a very important verse.
这是一句很重要的经文。
It holds all things together from this passage.
它把这一章所有的东西都放在了一起。
It's confusing.
非常让人混乱。
But let me describe it in a more simple way for you.
让我简单的向您解释一下。
There is something called the kingdom of God.
有一个东西叫做神的国。
The kingdom of God is not that everyone can live in that kingdom.
神的国并不代表说所有人都可以在神的国里。
But you know what? People that actually live in that kingdom, they exhibit some kind of qualities or characteristics that shows they belong there.
但是在神国的居民呢，他们有一些特定的品质，可以让人看出他们属于神国。
That Paul is saying,
保罗在这里说
that it's because of the persecutions and the sufferings that they've gone through.
因着这些弟兄姊妹所经历的迫害和痛苦
this actually shows that this is God's design for them to show that they actually belong to the kingdom of God.
这是神所设计的，让他们可以证明他们乃是属于神国的。
We need to be very, very careful here.
我们需要非常小心。
I am not saying.
我并不是说。
It's because of their persecutions and suffering.
因着他们所受到的痛苦
that they are now qualified to enter into the kingdom of God.
他们现在就配得神的国了。
It's like someone is waiting at the gate of the kingdom of God.
就像有人在神国的门口等的时候。
And you are about to enter it.
你正要进去。
And the guy will ask you, the guard will ask you, hey, have you suffered through persecutions?
门卫就问你说，你有没有经历过痛苦或者是迫害呢？
If you have not,
如果没有的话，
then you're rejected.
别进。
No, no, no. That's not what I'm saying.
这不是我所说的。
I am not saying.
我也不是说。
That, oh, if someone have suffered.
如果有人已经经受了痛苦。
That they have received a ticket to enter into the kingdom of God.
他们现在就有到了神国的门票。
No, no, no.
不是这样的。
This is not what this is saying.
这里不是这样说的。
Let me repeat it.
我再讲一遍。
It's because they are the citizens of this kingdom.
因为这些人已经是神国的子民。
And that because that they are citizens of this kingdom, they will suffer.
因着他们是神国的子民，他们必须经历痛苦。
And that this suffering is actually the proof that they are the citizens of this kingdom.
而这个痛苦呢，是他们是神国子民的证明。
That their sufferings are not in vain.
他们所经历的痛苦不是突然的。
That their suffering actually shows their identity as the citizens of the kingdom of God.
他们的痛苦呢，让他们是神国身份的这个身份显明了。
That sometime in the future, when Jesus comes again, when God's judgment comes to the world again,
在将来的某一天，当主耶稣回来的时候，当神的审判来临的时候
，That God's judgment will be shown.
神的审判就会让众人看到。
You, those who are being persecuted,
你们这些所有被迫害的。
You are the ones that belong to the kingdom of God. That's your identity.
你们属于神国，你们的身份就是神国。
You the ones that are persecuting my people.
你们那些凡是要迫害我的人的人。
You belong in eternal separation from me.
你们与我永永远远的隔离。
And you know, let's be careful of the word consider here. Here it says consider.
这里提到说 consider.
Consider.
下一句。
No. 可算配得。
可算配得。Consider. 可算。
算。
哦，算。
Consider. You know, are they truly worthy?
他们真的配得吗？
Are they truly worthy to be citizens of the kingdom of God?
他们真的配得神国的子民吗？
You know, only perfect people can be there.
只有完美的人，完全的人才配得。
Only completely righteous people can be there.
只有完全公义的人才属于那里。
No, they are not.
但是这些人不是的。
They are not completely perfect.
他们不可能是完美的。
But God considered them to be.
但是神把他们算为完美。
It's just like Abraham.
就像亚伯拉罕一样
，because he had faith in God, so God considered him to be righteous.
因为他在神里面有信心，所以神算他为义。
Abraham wasn't perfect.
亚伯拉罕不是一个完美的人。
You know, we have a lot of sisters here, right?
我们这儿有很多姐妹。
I'm pretty sure if you read the story of Abraham, you will agree he is not perfect.
你如果读亚伯拉罕的故事的话，你就会知道说他不是一个完美的人。
How he treated his wife.
他怎么对他老婆
？Right, I don't know if Uncle Peter mentioned it in his Sunday school, but that's not how you treat your wife.
我不记得刘长老有没有讲过，但是那不应该是你对你老婆的方式。
Hey, to pretend you're my sister, right? Pretend you're my sister, so I may live.
你就假装是我的妹妹，这样的话我能活着出去。
That's what he said, so I may live.
那是亚伯拉罕说的，我要活着。
Right, but God considered him to be righteous.
但是神还是。算他为义。
Here in the fourth assurance is that their suffering is the proof.
但是这里在第四个明证里面，他们的所遭受的痛苦就是那个证明。
That God's design is still working.
神的设计还是在进行。
That one day when God's judgment come.
当有一天神的审判来临的时候。
That they will be set apart and considered worthy and enter into the kingdom of God.
他们就会被分别出来，就会被算为配得神的国。
You know, in conclusion,
总结
，at last,
最后
，sometimes we may feel,
有时候我们会觉得
God, are you there?
神你在那儿吗？
In our waitings, in our wantings, in our seeking of God.
我们等啊，我们寻找啊，我们想要遇见神。
Sometimes it may seem like God is silent.
有时候我们觉得说神是无声无言的。
But God has given us his words.
但是神却给了我们他的话语。
And from the words here we can see.
我们透过神的话语可以看出
that God's work never stops.
神的工作从来没有停止过。
Even if we doubt it.
就算我们怀疑他。
Even if we question it.
就算我们提出异议。
But God's abundant blessing is still there.
但是神伟大的救恩却在那里。
We see these four assurances.
我们看到这四个确信。
We see that assurance that we are in Christ, we are in God, and that will never change.
我们看到有一个确信是我们在耶稣里，我们在神里，那个是永远不会改变的。
In the second assurance, it says that he will do his work and he will listen to prayers and he will never stop.
第二个确信是神会垂听我们的祷告，并且不停地让他的工作在我们当中进行。
In the third assurance, we can see that sufferings are actually of God's design. They are there for the good of us to build us up.
第三个确信是神让痛苦成为我们能够成长的一个方式，成为我们成长的一个礼物。
And in the fourth assurance, it shows that it is by these sufferings that shows our identity to the world.
第四个确信就是透过这样子的痛苦，这样子的挣扎，让我们神国子民的身份得以被彰显。
You know, we live in a world that teaches us things that are contrary to the Bible.
我们生活在一个世界里，就是这个世界常常告诉我们的一些东西都是和圣经背道而驰的。
The world tells us you need to seek peace, you need to seek comfort, you need to seek a life that is smooth.
世界告诉我们要追求一个和平，追求一个稳定，追求一个平安的生活。
I'm not saying this is bad.
我并不是说这是一个很差的。
I'm not saying today, tonight you go back to God and say, God, please give me suffering.
我并不是让你回家就向神祷告说，求你给我痛苦，给我挣扎。
What I am saying is,
我想说的是
，When trouble comes,
当困难来临的时候
，And oh, don't worry, it will come.
不用担心，一定会来的。
Rest assured, trouble will come into your lives.
不用担心，你的生命中都会经历。
When the trouble comes,
当它来临的时候
，We pray, I pray that we will have the right perspective.
我们求神给我们一个正确的眼光。
I pray that I will have the strength.
我求神让我有一个力量。
To know that no matter what kind of pain and suffering that I am going through.
让我知道无论经历到什么样的痛苦，什么样的苦难。
That God is there.
神还在那儿。
That God has not left us alone.
神并没有抛弃我们。
That God is still there, still loving and still working.
神还在那里，继续的爱着我们，继续的在我们生命中动他的善工。
Let us pray.
我们一起来祷告。
Lord, we pray that your words may become truth in our life.
主啊，我们求你的话语在我们生命中成为真实。
That these may not just be voices and sounds of men.
这不仅仅是人的碎言碎语。
That your words may enter into our lives so that we may be built up.
你的话语可以在我们生命中让我们可以被建造
so that we may know you more and more
以至于我们也可以更多的来认识你
we may know who you are
我们可以知道你是谁
we may know how much you love us
我们也知道你有多爱我们
we may know that you will never give us up
我们也知道你不会放弃我们
even if sometimes we give up on ourselves
就算有时候我们自己放弃我们自己
Lord that you are continuing there to be there to work in our lives
主啊，你还是在那里，还是继续在我们生命中动工。
That you have never left,
你从来没有离开过。
That you will never leave,
你也不会离开。
And God, please help us so that we may see, so that we may grow in you.
神啊，求你让我们看见，以至于我们可以在你里面长进。
We pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
奉耶稣基督的名求，
阿门。